Hello students, how are you? Last time we have done question number 4 from this chapter 4, quadratic equation. For the quadratic equation, you know very well, standard form is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Now we are starting question number 5 from exercise 4.3. What is statement? In a class test, the sum of Shefali's marks in mathematics and English is 30, had she got 2 marks more in mathematics and 3 marks less in English, the product of their marks would have been 210. Find her marks in 2 subjects. So, 2 subject test, total marks is given, that is 30. So, first you suppose, let marks in first you can take mathematics x, therefore you can say marks in English test, that is because total is 30, so in English test marks will be 30 minus x. Here this, then according to question, had she got 2 marks more in mathematics? According to question, marks in mathematics, 2 marks more, that is x plus 2, and marks in English, we think 3 marks less in English, 3 marks less. 30 minus x minus 3, 27 minus x. So according to, therefore their product of marks is 210. Their product of marks x plus 2 into 27 minus x is equal to 210. So now this is the main equation. It was told, first of all, this main equation should be correct. If main equation correct after simplification, then quadratic equation will come, it should be correct, then your answer will come correct. So now multiply x into something, 27x minus x square, 2 into something, 2 into 27, 54 minus 2x is equal to 210. So now it is, simplify this, 27 minus 2x, so minus x square plus 25x plus 54 minus 210 is equal to 0. I am shifting this 210 this side, so minus x square plus 25x minus 210 minus 54, because plus here, minus here, then you subtract 10 minus 4, 6, here, that is 150, 6 is equal to 0. So now, divide by minus 1, because if it is minus x square, then you are getting x square minus 25x plus 156 is equal to 0. This is the quadratic equation. Clear this? So, if you know the factorization, then okay. Otherwise, by D method, it means by using quadratic formula, you will find the solution of this, roots of this equation. So, equation is x square minus 25x plus 156 is equal to 0. So now my dear students, you check whether factorization possible or not. If not possible, then by D method you will solve. So if you don't know, then you can see, you forget, then in this way also you can check. So you see, it is divisible by 2, then 2 7 ja 14, 2 8 is 16, again 2, 2 3 is 2 9, again 2,
not divisible to 2 will be 3. Just you see, here factor 2 into this 78 and 2 factors, but I want 25, impossible. Now you see, 2 to the 4, 4 to here 12, and 12 multiply 3. This 12 multiply 3 is equal to 156. Then factors are 2 to the 4, 4, 3 is 12. Then 12 multiply 13. 12 multiply 13 is equal to 156. And 12 plus 13 is equal to 25. So, it means factorization method is also possible. Because if you multiply, then 156, if you add and subtract, minus 12 minus 13, minus 25 is coming. So now, x common, x minus 12, minus 13 common, x minus 12. So x minus 12 into x minus 13 is equal to 0. Product of two factors is 0. So what do you see? Either x minus 12 is equal to 0 or x minus 13 is equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to 12, x is equal to 13. So, 112, both are positive, both are the answer. So, what you suppose? X. X you suppose marks in mathematics. So, if marks in mathematics 12, so therefore in English it will be 25 minus 12, that is 13. Or you can say, no, not 13, it was given some of the marks are equal to 30. Then you state 30 minus 12, because some of the marks in mathematics in English is given 30. So if marks in 12, method 12, then in English 30 minus 12, 18. Now in this case, if marks in mathematics 13, then therefore in English, marks will be 30 minus 13, 17. Because some of the marks of both test is equal to 30 in the statement is given. So my dear students, both are the answer. This is also answer. This is also answer. So both are the answer. You can see 12 and 18. One answer also this. Second answer also this. 13 and 17. So both are the answer. Don't say then only one is the answer. Because both are the possible answers. You can understand. So now, one more question your series, question number 6. What is question number 6? Question number 6, I am doing the starting. In next time, I will ask the solution whether you can solve or not. What is question number 6? You see, the diagonal of rectangular field is 60 meter more than the shorter side. The diagonal of rectangular field. This is the rectangular field. Its diagonal is 60 meter more than shorter side. This is shorter side, you say. Let shorter side is x meter and diagonal is 60 meter more than the shorter side. It is x plus 60 meter. And next is saying, if the longer side is 30 meter more than the shorter side. Longer side is 30 meter more than the shorter side. Then he is saying, find the sides of the field. Find the sides of field. Now, I think statement is clear. Because in this he is saying, diagonal is 60 more than the shorter side, then it means you suppose first. This is question number 6. Let shorter side is equal to x meter. So therefore, diagonal is equal to x plus 6 and longer side is equal to x plus 30 meter. Clear this? So it is ABCD is a rectangle. What you see in right triangle ABC by Pythagoras theorem. You know where is square? P square plus B square is equal to H square. So what is perpendicular? X, this is X square base X plus 30 square is equal to hypotenuse square, it is X plus 60 square. So my dear students, from the statement, from the words problem we are reading, and this is the main equation. What next step? We have to solve this and then make the y equation. Now it is x square a plus b whole square. So a square plus b square plus 2a into b, and this side a square plus b square plus 2a into b. So x square 2x square plus 30 square 900 plus 60x is equal to x square, it is 60 whole square, 60 into 60, 60 into 2, 120x. Now shift all terms left hand side, 2x square plus 900 plus 60x minus x square minus 3600 minus 120x is equal to 0. 2x square minus x square 60 minus 120 minus 60x, and this side minus 3600, so this is minus 2600. So this is the quadratic equation, x square minus 60x minus 27 is equal to 0. So this is the main equation, and now we are simplifying. It is a quadratic equation, so this it must be correct. If it is wrong, then the roots will come wrong. So tell me the factors of this. Here, factors of this, you think over it. What are the possible factors of this equation? If I multiply, it should be 2700, but if you add and subtract, it should be minus 60. So you see here x square minus 60x minus 2700 is equal to 0. So factors, you can simple, you see 27 table in 9 3 are 27. So 90 into 30, 2700, 90 minus 30, 60. In this way, you minus, then large number minus. Minus 90x plus 60 minus 27 is equal to 0. Oh, sorry, it is minus 90 max plus 30, because 90 into 30 2700, and 90 minus 30 is 60 is coming. Then it is correct. 90 minus 90 plus 30, it is minus 60 is 30. If I have written 60, but here you see it is coming 30, but it is wrong. So this is a factor. Now take common, x common, x minus 90 plus 30 common, x minus 90. So x minus 90, x plus 30. So product of two factors are 0. Product of two factors are 0, it means either this 0 or this 0. So x plus 30 is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 30. What you see, this is rejected. Why? Because length of side can't be negative. So this is rejected. You have to write the reason for rejected. Now this side x is equal to 90. So therefore, what do you say? Shorter side is equal to 90 meter. Longer side is equal to 90 plus 30. That is, or you can write diagonal also, no problem. And because diagonal is given x plus 60. Clear this? So 90 plus 60, 150 meter. Understand? So this is the answer because the rectangle given in this way, because this angle 90. So apply Pythagoras theorem in this way, you can show. Clear this? So other parts, other questions also revise yourself. Do your trial. Thank you and good day.